Hi, my name is Donna Larson, and I've been attending Sailorville since 2007. I became a child of God when I was 9 years old. I grew up in a Midwest, hardworking farm family. I was the middle child of five, and I was always a very quiet, insecure, scared child. Well, I got so wrapped up in my fears, sometimes I had trouble even going to sleep at night. And it got so bad, and I became so anxious, I gathered up every bit of courage I could one night, and I decided I would tiptoe into my mother's and father's bedroom, and I would ask them, what happens if I die? So that's what I did. I tiptoed into my parents' bedroom. My parents were asleep after, I'm sure, a long day of hard work on the farm and taking care of their kids. And I tiptoed up next to my mom and I said, Mom, can we talk? And she did a normal response of any hardworking farm woman that had finally gotten to bed. She said, oh, cannot wait till the morning. And of course, then my courage was destroyed. So I rushed back to bed, jumped into my bed, but it could not wait until morning. I needed an answer then. And it was at that moment that all those memory verses that I had memorized and hid in my heart started scrolling through my brain. But now I believe, under the ministry of the Holy Spirit, those verses came to life and they made sense to me. Those verses told me I was a sinner. I did have a problem. So that night in my bedroom, all by myself, I just talked to God and I told him, God, I know I'm a sinner. I believe that Jesus died for my sins and came alive, and I want to be saved. And at that moment, I had peace. Since then, God has taught me a few more things about being his child. He's taught me how to walk with him. He's taught me that as I walk with him, there are things about myself that have to be changed so that I can become more like Jesus. One of the things he has had to change or help me with is my problem with fear. I still was a fearful person. And in high school, I felt called to Bible college, after graduation, go on to Bible college, and then become a missionary in Africa. But I was too fearful to pursue that. So I didn't even say anything to my parents or anyone that might have been able to help me get there. I let my fear keep me from pursuing what I felt was God's will for my life at that point. One of the things that God did for me that is kind of a little bit humorous is that instead of going off to Bible school and then to Africa, he brought a man into my life, Chuck Larson, who I would eventually marry. And I didn't know it at the time. I just saw him as he was the preacher's son. He was good looking. He was well educated. He was driven. He was ready to go on to medical school. And I fell in love with him. And I thought, oh, here is a safe place for me. God has provided a safe place for me. Little did I know that I was about to marry a man who, in his own words, knows no fear. I began to appreciate that my fear is my thorn in the flesh. I have prayed for God to take it away. It's not happened. But each time I face a new fear, I now know that God is greater than my fear. And it's my little signal to just go to God and to trust Him. Another thing that God has really taught me and dealt with me on is the issue of unforgiveness. My family all are tremendous at holding grudges. So I saw my family handling relationships that way, and that was the way I handled relationships. Well, God would take something very dramatic to confront my my tendency towards unforgiveness. And that was my husband's revelation that my husband was dealing with a private secret sin. When that sin became revealed, I was very angry. I felt we had a perfect family. I felt that I was being a godly, submissive wife following after him. I felt that I had done a great job at raising our children, and I felt that when the secret sin was discovered, that he had intentionally wounded me, and I was very, very angry. And it took a long time for me to forgive him. God did it by allowing me to see my own sin, to see the sin that I had made my children an idol, and I felt what their father had done had damaged my children, and I was angry that my hard work of raising up my children to know the Lord in my mind had been destroyed by his sinful act. I was, God revealed my sin of inappropriate pride in our marriage, that I was prideful of how good our marriage looked on the outside, that people would come up to me and even compliment our relationship and ask what's the secret to our marriage. And of course, I went to God and I asked him to forgive me, and I received his forgiveness. Well, then it was the natural step then for him to direct me to look at Chuck's sin and say, you know what, Donna? I've forgiven you. Now you can forgive your husband. At that time in the Word, God brought to light a passage that really spoke volumes to me. It was the story of the woman that brought the alabaster jar to Jesus, and she broke it, and she poured oil on his feet. She anointed him, and those standing around started whining about this. How could she spend all that money on doing that? And at the end of the story, Jesus says to them, you know, those that have been forgiven much, love much. And I realized that was me. I was a woman who had been forgiven much. And that just broke me. And I fell in love with Jesus even more, and God gave me the ability to forgive my husband.